Admission of a new partner, Class 12 Accountancy. Myself, Kishore Chauhan, and I welcome all the students on my YouTube channel, Guru of Accountancy. Dear students, today in this video, we will learn how to solve exercise on admission of a new partner. In this video, I will show accounting treatment when a new partner is admitted. As you all are aware, that when a new partner is admitted, he brings capital and he also brings premium for goodwill. In this video, we will learn how to give accounting treatment of capital as well as the premium for goodwill brought by a new partner. We will also learn how to find new profit sharing ratio and how to find sacrificing ratio. In short, in this video, we are going to learn solution of exercise on admission of a new partner. So let us begin. Accounting treatment. In this chapter, dear students, you have to prepare revaluation account on admission of a new partner. Assets and liabilities are revalued and we have to find profit or loss on revaluation and reassessment of assets and liabilities. So we will prepare revaluation account. We have to also find new profit sharing ratio among all the partners and also sacrificing ratio of the old partners. We have to also prepare partners capital account and or current account as the case may be. If the method is given fixed capital account method, then you have to prepare partners current account also. But in fluctuating capital account method, we prepare only partners capital account. And we will also learn preparation of balance sheet after admission of a new partner. So let us see some of the exercise and try to learn how to solve exercise on admission of a new partner. See this exercise. Given below is the balance sheet of A and B, who are carrying on partnership business as on March 31st, March 2017. A and B share profit in the ratio 2:1. So A and B are the partners and their profit sharing ratio is 2:1. This is their old ratio. Now the balance sheet is given. On asset side, you can see cash in hand, cash at bank, sundry debtors, stock, plant and machinery and building. These are the different assets given. On the liability side, you can see bills payable, sundry creditor, outstanding expense and capital of both the partners are given. So this is the balance sheet on 31st March 2017. Adjustments are given. C is admitted as a partner on the date of the balance sheet on the following terms. So new partner Mr. C is admitted. C will bring rupees 1 lakh as his capital and rupees 60,000 as his share of goodwill for 1/4 share in profit. So first adjustment says that new partner Mr. C will bring rupees 1 lakh. So we will pass the entry bank account debit to Mr. C's capital account. This would be your entry and we will post it. And rupees 60,000 as his share of goodwill. So 60,000 rupees is the premium for goodwill which a new partner will get. Sorry, new partner will bring. This premium for goodwill will be distributed among the sacrificing partner. That means old partner. If they are sacrificing, then it will be distributed among them in their sacrificing ratio. So we will find sacrificing ratio if information is given. If it is not given, then their old ratio will be the sacrificing ratio. Plant is to be appreciated by rupees 1 lakh 20,000. So the value of plant we have to keep up to 1 lakh 20,000. And the value of building is to be appreciated by 10%. Here, try to understand, in plant, they have written 2 rupees 1 lakh 20,000. So already the value of plant is given 1 lakh and we have to make it to 1 lakh 20,000. So 20,000 is increase in plant. So this is gain that we will write in the revaluation account credit side. And we will also add 20,000 in plant. So new value will be 1,20,000. The value of building is to be appreciated by 10%. So the value of building is given. rupees 1,50,000, and this building is appreciated by 10%. So 10% of 1,50,000 is 15,000. 15,000 we will add in building, and it is a increase. So we will write revaluation account credit side. Stock is found overvalued by rupees 4,000. So the value of stock is given 40,000, and it is overvalued by 4,000. So actually its value is 36,000 because 4,000 is overvalued. So what we will do? 4,000 we will minus in the balance sheet from this 40,000. So the new value of the stock would be 36,000. And 4,000 decrease in the stock, we will write revaluation account debit side. Next adjustment, a provision for doubtful debt is to be created at 5% of debtors. So debtors are given rupees 60,000, 5% of 60,000, that is 3,000. We will create provision for doubtful debt. One effect, revaluation account debit side, and second effect, 3,000 rupees minus from debtors. Creditors were unrecorded to the extent of 1,000. So creditor is one type of liability. 1,000 liability has increased. So revaluation account debit side we will write. And in balance sheet, new balance sheet, we will add in sundry creditors 1,000. So now new creditor would be 59,000 because already 58,000 is given and 1,000 has increased. So it is now 59,000. Now what they have asked? They have asked prepare revaluation account, partners capital accounts, and the balance sheet of the constituted firm after admission of new partner. So first of all, we will prepare the revaluation account. In revaluation account, we will write the adjustment number 2, 3, 4, and 5, because they are about revaluation and reassessment of assets and liabilities. So see, plant is appreciated to rupees 1,20,000. We have seen 20,000 is increased, and building is appreciated by 10%. So both this item will go revaluation account credit side. So you can see buy plant and machinery 20,000 and building 15,000 is recorded in revaluation account credit side. This is the solution. Stock has decreased by 4,000 because it is overvalued by 4,000. So we have decreased it. So 4,000 we will write revaluation account debit. On debtors, 3,000 is provision for doubtful debt that we write on the debit side, and creditors has increased by 1,000. So that is written on debit side. Thereafter, we will make the total after giving the effect of all these five adjustments. So total is coming 35,000, and difference is coming on the debit side 27,000. This is profit on revaluation of assets and liabilities. This 27,000 profit, dear student, we will distribute among the old partners A and B in their old ratio. And the old ratio was already given in the exercise 2:1. So this profit on revaluation, rupees 27,000, is distributed between A and B in old ratio 2:1. So A is getting 18,000 and B is getting 9,000. Journal entry for this profit will be revaluation account debit to A's capital and to B's capital. It will be recorded on the capital account credit side. Thereafter, we will prepare partners capital account. In the partners capital account, first of all, credit side, we will write their opening balance of A and B. So you can see on March 31st, it is written by balance brought down, Mr. A 1,80,000 and Mr. B 1,50,000. So this is the opening capital given in the balance sheet liability side, capital of A and B 180 and 150. We have given the adjustment. Number one, C will bring rupees 1,00,000 as his capital. So entry would be bank account debit to C's capital. So that we will write on the credit side of capital account. You can see in the capital account credit side, by bank is written, and in the column of C, rupees 1,00,000 is given because capital brought by Mr. C 1,00,000. Okay, this 1,00,000 rupees we will also add in bank. In the asset side, in bank balance, we will add this 1,00,000. So Already in the balance sheet, we have cash at bank 40,000. In that we will add 1 lakh. So now cash at bank will become 1,40,000. One more important thing. Adjustment number one says he brings 60,000 as his share of goodwill. So entry for this would be bank account debit to premium for goodwill. 60,000 bank account debit to premium for goodwill. This 60,000 will be added in the bank. So now we have total bank balance on the asset side, 2 lakh rupees. Already 1 lakh was there. 1 lakh is capital brought by C and 60,000 premium for goodwill. So total cash at bank is now 2 lakh. Now this premium for goodwill is distributed among the old partner in their sacrificing ratio. Dear student, in this exercise, new ratio is not given. So sacrificing ratio will be old ratio. That is, sacrificing ratio will be 2:1. So 60,000 rupees brought by Mr. C will be distributed between A and B in their old ratio, that is sacrificing ratio 2:1. So your entry would be, first entry was bank account debit to premium for goodwill 60,000. Second entry would be premium for goodwill account debit 60,000 to A's capital and to B's capital. 60,000 will be distributed between A and B in 2:1. So its effect will go on capital account credit side. You can see third item is written credit side by goodwill 40,000 and 20,000, total 60,000 distributed in 2:1. So this is adjustment about premium for goodwill. So first adjustment is already over. In the first adjustment, capital is 1 lakh and premium for goodwill is 60,000. So our first entry was bank account debit to C's capital 1 lakh. Second entry was bank account debit to premium for goodwill 60,000. And the third entry was premium for goodwill rupees 60,000 to A's capital 40,000 and B's capital 20,000. So already we gave the effect of adjustment number one. Amount brought by new partner is added in bank. So now our new bank balance is 2 lakh rupees because already 1 lakh was there, and this 1,60,000, they, because already bank balance was 40,000, and in that this 1,60,000 will be added. So new balance will be rupees 2 lakh. Adjustment number 2, 3, 4, and 5, we have already recorded in the revaluation account. Only second effect in the balance sheet is left. So you can see in the balance sheet, asset side, from debtors 3,000 we have minus because there is a provision for doubtful debt of 3,000. So now new debtor are 57,000. Value of stock was overvalued by 4,000. So we have minus from the stock overvaluation, you have to minus. So we have minus, so now new value is 36,000. Value of plant and machinery, earlier it was 1 lakh, in that we have added 20,000. So now it is 1,20,000. Billing was earlier 1,50,000, in that we have added 15,000 increase, 10% increase. So now it is 1,60,000. On the liability side, sundry creditors were 58,000, and in that we have added 1,000, which were not recorded. So now creditors are 59,000. Bills payable will be recorded as it is 10,000 because there is no adjustment. Outstanding expense also 2,000 as it is because there is no adjustment. Now, let us once again go to the capital account. Credit side, first we wrote the opening capital, then capital brought by Mr. C by bank 1 lakh, then goodwill distributed in sacrificing ratio 40,000 and 20,000. One more important point, in the revaluation account, we have profit 27,000. It is distributed among the old partner in old ratio. So our entry is revaluation account debit 27,000 to A's capital 18,000 and B's capital 9,000. So second effect will go capital account credit side. You can see by revaluation profit 18,000 and 9,000. So all the adjustments are over. Now we will close the capital account. So we are getting balance on the debit side of Mr. A 2,38,000, Mr. B 1,79,000 and Mr. C 1 lakh. This is their capital balance. This will be recorded in the new balance sheet on the liability side. So see, on the new balance sheet on the liability side, you can see capital of all the three partner is given A, B, and C, 2,38,000, 1,79,000, and 1,00,000. So now total capital is 5,17,000. Once again, we see adjustment number one already we recorded. Adjustment number two of plant and building we recorded. Stock also we recorded. Provision for doubtful debt also we recorded. Creditors also we recorded. So all the adjustments are over. Then all the items of balance sheet also we have recorded in the new balance sheet, like this bills payable as it is we recorded, outstanding expense as it is we recorded. So finally, we will close the balance sheet, and our balance sheet both side total is coming 5,88,000. So in this exercise, I have tried to explain you how to give effect, how to pass the journal entry, and in which ratio particular item is distributed. Remember, revaluation profit or loss is distributed in old ratio. Premium for goodwill brought by a new partner is distributed in sacrificing ratio. Here sacrificing ratio was not given, so we have taken the old ratio as sacrificing ratio. So this was our illustration number one. Now let us see one more exercise, illustration number two. Divya, Yasmin and Fatima are partners in a firm, sharing profit and loss in the ratio 11:7:2, respectively. So their profit sharing ratio is given and three partners are given. Their balance sheet on 31st March 18 is given. Factory building is there, plant and machinery, furniture, stock, debtors. From that they have minus provision. And outer column it is coming 1,20,000. Cash at bank is given 1,59,000. Provision is 30,000. By mistake it is written below cash at bank. Debtors are 1,50,000 minus provision 30,000. So outer column 1,20,000. On the liability side, sundry creditors are given, public deposit is given, reserve fund is given, outstanding expense is given, and partners' capitals are given. Remember, whenever any profit or reserve given on the liability side, that we have to distribute among the old partner in their old ratio. So this reserve fund 90,000, it belongs to old partner, so it will be distributed among all the three partner in their old ratio 11:7:2. Entry for this would be reserve fund account debit to Divya's capital account, Yasmin's capital account and Fatima's capital account in 11:7:2. We will distribute this 90,000. Let us see the adjustment. On 1st April 2018, Aditya is admitted as a partner for 1/5 share in the profit with a capital of rupees 4,50,000 and necessary amount of his share of goodwill on the following terms. So in this exercise, a new partner will bring capital 4,50,000. So your entry would be bank account debit to Aditya's capital account 4,50,000. In bank we will add, and capital account credit side we will write 4,50,000. One important point here, the amount of goodwill is not given, but it is written necessary amount. So we have to find the goodwill share of Aditya. That we will do in the working. Adjustment number one, furniture of rupees 2,40,000 were taken by Divya, Yasmin and Fatima equally. So in the question, furniture is given. You can see furniture is given 2,60,000. Out of that, 2,40,000 is taken by all the three partners in their profit sharing ratio 11:7:2. So dear student, remember when any partner takes away a set, then their capital account is debited. So our entry would be Divya's capital account debit, Yasmin's capital account debit, Fatima's capital account debit to furniture. And it is equally. So 2,40,000 divided by 3. So 80,000 will be debited in their capital account to furniture 2,40,000. What effect we will give? Capital account debit side we will write of the partner, and from furniture in new balance sheet we will minus 2,40,000. So now our furniture is only 20,000 because out of 2,60,000, 2,40,000 is taken away by the three partners. Creditor of 7,000 not recorded in the books taken to be account. So creditor is not recorded. So we will add in the creditor in the balance sheet, and in revaluation account debit side, we will give effect of this because it has increased our liability. Third point is given of goodwill. Goodwill of the firm is to be valued at 2.5 years of purchase of average profit of the last 2 years. The profit of the last 3 years is given 15, 16, 6 lakh, 16, 17, 2 lakh, and 17, 18, 6 lakh. Very clearly it is given average profit of the last 2 years. So we will take the average profit of the last 2 years. We will find firm's goodwill, and in that we will get the share of new partner. Fourth point, at the time of Aditya's admission, Yasmin also brought 50,000 as fresh capital. So Yasmin has brought 50,000 as fresh capital. So entry would be bank account debit to Yasmin's capital account. It will be added in the bank, and Yasmin's capital account credit side, we will record this. Plant and machinery is revalued at 2 lakh rupees. Let us see the value of plant and machinery. It is 1,80,000 given, and now its new value is 2 lakh. So 20,000 is increase in the plant and machinery. So 20,000 we will record in the revaluation account credit side, and 20,000 we will add in the plant. So now our new value of the plant in the new balance sheet would be 2 lakh. Because 1,80,000 was already there, in that 20,000 we will add, so it will become 2 lakh. Expenses outstanding were brought down to 9,000. See the old balance sheet, outstanding expenses are given 10,000, but its new value is now 9,000, so 1,000 decrease. So it is our gain. So 1,000 we will write in the revaluation account credit side, and in new balance sheet, outstanding expense, we will write only 9,000 because now its new value is 9,000. Now, what is the question? Prepare revaluation account, partner's capital account, and the balance sheet. So let us see the solution of this exercise. First of all, revaluation account. As I told you, value of machinery has increased by 20,000. So credit side of revaluation account. Outstanding expenses have decreased. So it is gain. So revaluation account credit side by outstanding expense 1,000. So total is 21,000. On the debit side, unrecorded creditor we recorded, two creditors 7,000. So ultimately we are getting the difference 14,000. It is revaluation profit. And this revaluation profit, as I told you, will be distributed among the old partners in their old ratio. So your entry would be revaluation account debit 14,000 to Divya's capital, to Yasmin's capital, and to Fatima's capital in their old ratio. And old ratio, we already know it is 11:7:2. So second effect of this revaluation profit, we will give in the capital account credit side. So this is revaluation account. In machinery, we will add 20,000 in the balance sheet. Outstanding expense, we will minus in the new balance sheet. Creditors, we will add in the new balance sheet. Now, adjustment about goodwill. In the question, it is said, firm's goodwill, we have to calculate. See the adjustment number 3. Goodwill of the firm is to be valued at 2.5 years purchase of the average profit of the last 2 years. You can see the last 2 years profit is given here, 2 lakh rupees and 6 lakh rupees. So first we have to find the average profit. So firm's goodwill is equal to average profit, 2 lakh plus 6 lakh divided by 2, because 2 years, so divided by 2. So we will get the average profit 4 lakh, because total is 8 divided by 2. So 4 lakh divided into 2.5 years. So 10 lakh will be the firm's goodwill. In this, we have to find Aditya's share of goodwill. Now, new partner Aditya, his share is 1/5. So 10 lakh, 1/5 of 10 lakh is 2 lakh rupees. So Mr. Aditya will bring 2 lakh rupees as a premium for goodwill. And this premium for goodwill, we will distribute among the old partner in their sacrificing ratio. So Let us see the partners' capital account. First of all, we will write the capital of all the three partners, credit side by balance brought down. It is given in the balance sheet as it is, we copy. Then by bank account, Yasmin has brought additional capital 50,000 and Aditya has brought 450,000. Entry is bank account debit to Aditya's capital account, bank account debit to Yasmin's capital account. Reserve fund is given in the question. As I told you, any reserve given in the question on the liability side, we distribute among the old partner in old ratio. So 90,000 will be distributed in the 11:7:2. So your entry would be reserve fund account debit to partner's capital account. So partner's capital account credit side by reserve fund, 49,500, 31,500 and 9,000. 90,000 is distributed in old ratio. Now premium for goodwill, we calculated 2 lakh. Entry would be bank to premium for goodwill. We will add in bank. And second, premium for goodwill account debit to Divya's capital account, Yasmin's capital account and to Fatima's capital account in sacrificing ratio. Now in this question, new ratio is not given. So old ratio would be the sacrificing ratio. So 2 lakh we have distributed into 11:7:2 ratio. So three partners are getting 1,10,000, 70,000 and 20,000. At last, revaluation profit is written, which we found in the revaluation account. You can see 7,700, 4,900 and 1,400. Entry is revaluation account debit to partner's capital account. So second effect, we will write in the partner's capital account credit side by revaluation account. This is a profit. So all the items of the credit side, I explain you. Furniture, one adjustment was there. Adjustment number first, furniture of rupees 2,40,000 were to be taken over by Divya, Yasmin and Fatima equally. So entry would be Divya's capital account debit 80,000, Yasmin's capital account debit 80,000, Fatima's capital account debit 80,000, two furniture 2,40,000. So it will be recorded on the debit side of the capital account. You can see two furniture account 80,000, 80,000, 80,000. Then we will find the balance. So finally the balance is coming of all the four partner, which is given here on the debit side, 5,97,200. 3,76,400, 4,50,400 and 4,50,000. This is a balance of capital, which we will show in the new balance sheet liability side. So see the new balance sheet. On the new balance sheet liability side, sundry creditor is written 77,000. Earlier it was 70,000 and 7,000 is increased. Public deposit as it is, we will write outstanding expense. Earlier it was 10,000, now 9,000 because 1,000 has decreased. Capital account is written of all the four partner, which we took from the partner's capital account. Asset side, factory building is written, plant machinery is written and furniture. You can see only 20,000 written because out of 2,60,000, 2,40,000 is taken away by three partner. So remaining furniture would be 20,000. Stock is written. Debtors as it is, we have recorded. Important is cash at bank. For that, we have prepared here bank account. First of all, credit debit side, two balance brought down, 1,59,000 opening balance, which is given in the question itself. You can see bank balance is given 1,59,000. On the asset side, last item 1,59,000 that we will record. So bank account debit side, two balance brought down, opening balance 1,59,000. Then Aditya brought 4,50,000 of capital. So entry is bank account debit to Aditya's capital. So debit side we posted it. Aditya also brought 2,00,000 rupees as a premium for goodwill, as we have done the working. So bank account debit to premium for goodwill, 2,00,000 rupees. Yasmin also brought fresh capital. So bank account debit to Yasmin's capital 50,000. So we have total bank balance 8,59,000 and it will be shown in the new balance sheet. So you can see on the asset side, last item cash at bank 8,59,000. And ultimately the total is coming 20,79,000 of both the side. So dear student, in this exercise, we have covered so many new points. Say, for example, first point was reserve fund. We distributed among the old partner in old ratio. Thereafter, we also learned how to find goodwill as per the average profit method and how to find the share of the new partner and how to distribute this premium for goodwill among the old partner in sacrificing ratio. So this is the important point here. If you have any doubt, you can put comment. Now we shift to exercise number three. Let us see the exercise number three. Following is the balance sheet of Sasi and Asu sharing profit in the ratio 3:2. So we have two partner, Sasi and Asu, and their profit sharing ratio is 3:2. See the asset side, debtors are given 22,000. From that provision for doubtful debt is minus 1,000. So outer column 21,000. Land building is given, plant machinery is given, stock is given, and bank is given. On the liability side, creditors are given, general reserve is given, workmen compensation fund and capital of both the partner is given. As I told you, general reserve we distribute among the old partner in their old ratio. Similar to this, workmen compensation fund is also, if there is no liability is given for workmen compensation, then this amount will be also distributed among the old partner in old ratio. But if some liability is given, then that amount we will minus and remaining amount we will distribute. Let us see the exercise. On admission of Tanya, a new partner, for 1/6 share in the profit, it was decided that provision for doubtful debt is to be increased by 1500. So already provision for doubtful debt is given 1000 in the question, and it is increased to by rupees 1500. So total provision would be now 2500, because by word is used. So from 22,000 we will minus 2500. 1500 has increased, so revaluation account debit side we will write 1500. Second, value of land and building to be increased to rupees 21,000. The word 2 is written here, so we have to make the value of land and building 21,000. Here already 18,000 is given. Now we have to make 21,000. So 3,000 is increased. So here 3,000 we will add, and revaluation account credit side 3,000 increase in land and building we will write. Value of stock to be increased by ₹2,500. So in the stock, in the new balance sheet, we will add 2,500. And second effect of 2,500 revaluation credit side. The liability of workmen compensation fund was determined to be 12,000. Now see, here liability is given 12,000. And already in the question, workmen compensation fund is given 15,000 rupees. So out of 15,000, 12,000 we will write on the liability side, workmen compensation liability, and remaining 3,000 we will distribute among the old partner in their old ratio. This is an important point. As the adjustment for the workmen compensation liability is given for 12,000, that much amount we will keep on the liability side, and remaining 3,000 we will distribute among the old partner in old ratio. So this is the important point of this exercise. Tanya brought in as her share of goodwill ₹10,000 in cash. So entry would be cash account debit to premium for goodwill. And this premium for goodwill, we will distribute among the old partner in their sacrificing ratio. So entry would be premium for goodwill account debit 10,000 to old partners in their sacrificing ratio. If sacrificing ratio is not given, old ratio will be considered as sacrificing ratio. Here new ratio is not given, so we will distribute in 3:2 between Sasi and Asu. Tanya was to bring further cash of ₹15,000 for her capital. So 15,000 she brings as a capital. So cash account debit to Tanya's capital 15,000. Now what is the question? Prepare revaluation account, partner's capital account, and balance sheet. Let us see the solution. First, revaluation account. On asset side, first we will write land and building 3000 and buy stock 2500, because you can see the adjustment. Number two, land and building has increased ₹21,000. Earlier it was 18,000, now it is 21,000. So 3000 is increased. So we will write 3000 on revaluation credit side. Stock has also increased by 2500. So 2500 we will write on credit side of revaluation account. Provision for doubtful debt has increased by 1500. So it will go on the debit side. After making total, we are getting 4000 profit on revaluation. This 4000 will be distributed among the old partners, Sasi and Asu, in their old ratio 3:2. So Sasi is getting 2400 and Asu is getting 1600. So your entry would be revaluation account debit to Sasi's capital account 2400 to Asu's capital account 1600. Second effect of this will be given in the capital account credit side. Now let us see the partner's capital account. First, we write on the credit side opening balance of the old partner by balance brought down 15,000 and 10,000, already given in the question. General reserve we distribute between them in their old ratio by general reserve 15,000 and 10,000. Workmen compensation fund, only 3,000 we will distribute. So by workmen compensation fund account 1,800 and 1,200, it is distributed among the old partner in old ratio. By revaluation account, this is revaluation profit which we found in the revaluation account, 2,400 and 1,600. It is also distributed among the old partner in old ratio. By bank 15,000, it is the capital brought by new partner Tanya. And Tanya also brings premium for goodwill 10,000. So entry is cash account debit to premium for goodwill 10,000. And this 10,000 is distributed among them in sacrificing ratio, here old ratio. So premium for goodwill account debit to Sasi's capital account 6,000, to Asu's capital account 4,000. There is no adjustment on the debit side. So finally, we are getting the balance of all the three partner 40,200, 26,800 and 15,000. Dear student, here important point is premium for goodwill we distribute in the sacrificing ratio. If not given, then in old ratio. Revaluation profit we distribute in old profit sharing ratio. Workmen compensation fund and general reserve we distribute among the old partner in old ratio. Important point in workmen compensation fund, out of 15,000, only 3,000 is distributed because 12,000 is a liability, which we will show on the liability side. So now let us see the new balance sheet. New balance sheet, you can see liability side. First item is creditor is written 18,000. In the question, creditors are given 18,000 as it is copied. Workmen compensation fund, you can see 12,000 is written. It is workmen compensation liability, 12,000. Capital of all the three partners is written 40,200, 26,800 and 15,000, which we have found in the capital account. On the asset side, debtors 22,000 is already given. From that we minus the provision, which is given in the question. 1,500 we have to increase, and already 1,000 is given. So total we have to minus 2,500. So from 20,000, if we minus 2,500, so it will come 19,500. But here 19,000 written, this is a printing mistake. It is 19,500. 22,000 debtors minus 2,500. Land and building, we wrote plant and machinery, we wrote after the plus minus, whatever is the adjustment, stock is written and bank balance is written 46,000. How 46,000 bank balance come? That is also important. See, the bank balance is given 21,000. Thereafter here it is given, Tanya brought 15,000. So 21 plus 15, 36. Tanya also brought brought goodwill 10,000. So in this way, it is coming 46,000. All the items we have recorded, both side total is coming 1,12,000. So dear student, in this exercise, our important point was about workmen compensation fund. We have not distributed 15,000. We have distributed only 3,000 because 12,000 was the liability, and that 12,000 we have shown on the liability side. Second important point was the debtors. Debtors were given already 1,000. From that we have to minus 2,500 because 1,500 has increased. So outer column 19,500. As I told you, here there is a printing mistake. So this is all about solution of exercise on admission of a new partner. Dear student, I have tried to explain you many important points. Thank you. Keep watching my videos on this chapter as well as other chapters. Subscribe, share, and like this video. Thank you very much.